teaching class of Department of Urology, SMS Medical College. And today we have a teaching class on guidelines on testicular tumors. And this would be presented by our resident, Dr. Mukesh Beniwal. And the session would be moderated by our faculty, Dr. Sanjeev Jaiswal. And we will have our guest faculty. I think Dr. H.S. Pawa might be joining us any time. And so...
Jaiswal ne abhi join nahi kiya sir?
Dr. Jaiswal is in the classroom.
Achha, he's in the classroom.
Right. Theek hai. So I would request now our moderator, Dr. Jaiswal, to kindly ask the presenter to start the session.
Hello.
Yes, yes, Mukesh. Yes.
Good morning and welcome you all. I would request to Dr. Mukesh to share his presentation on testicular cancer. Dr. Mukesh, please.
मिस्टर से बोलो हो गया टाइम मैडम को
ट्राई टू रिड्यूस द डिस्टरबेंस दैट इज कमिंग फ्रॉम द साउंड सो ऑल ऑफ यू आर रिक्वेस्टेड दोज हु हैव प्लीज म्यूट देमसेल्फ
गुड मॉर्निंग टीचर्स एंड रेजिडेंट्स
So we have our residents in the classroom present, and there are a few who are joining online, so it's a hybrid session. Mr. Nimesh, I think, okay, fine, thank you.
Good morning, teachers and residents. Today I am presenting a seminar on guidelines on STI testis. Testicular cancer represents 1% of the adult neoplasm, and the most common histology is germ cell tumor, broadly divided into three categories, seminoma, non-seminoma, and germ cell neoplasia in situ. Brief on TNM stages. T1 is tumor limited to testis and epidermis without vascular invasion, or tumor may invade tunica albuginea but not tunica vaginalis. T2 is similar as T1 except with invasion of lymphovascular invasion and may invade tunica vaginalis. T3 tumor invade spermatic cord with or without lymphovascular invasion, and T4 is tumor invades scrotum with or without lymphovascular invasion. And in the lymph node staging, N1 is lymph node up to 2 cm and N2 in more than 2 to 5 cm in greatest dimension, and N3 is more than 5 cm. And pathological staging is similar as clinical staging, except number of lymph nodes up to 5 number of lymph nodes is considered in N1 and more than 5 considered in N2, and N3 is more than 5 cm lymph node, single or multiple lymph nodes. And M1 is distant metastasis. M1A is non-regional nodal mets or pulmonary mets. M1B is other than M1A. And the serum tumor markers are divided into S1, S2, S3 according to range. And stage grouping, S1 is considered only primary tumor, and stage 2 considered nodal metastasis. Stage 2 is further divided into A, B, C according to N1 in stage 2A and N2, stage 2B and N3, stage 3C. And stage 3 is metastasis. And other classification, International Germ Cell Cancer Collaborative Group, risk classification used only for advanced germ cell tumor. In this classification, seminoma is divided in three groups: good prognosis, intermediate, and poor prognosis. In the good prognosis, testicular or retroperitoneal primary and no non-pulmonary visceral mets and good markers all. And in intermediate prognosis, all same as good prognosis except in intermediate markers. And in the poor prognosis, mediastinal primary or non-pulmonary visceral mets or poor serum markers. And in seminoma is divided only two groups, in good prognosis and intermediate, no poor prognosis. No group in the poor prognosis. Good prognosis is any primary site and no non-pulmonary visceral mets and normal alpha fetoprotein and any HCG and LDH. In the intermediate seminoma, any primary sites and non-pulmonary metastasis and normal alpha fetoprotein and any HCG and LDH. Diagnostic evaluation according to EAA guidelines. First option is physical examination, then USG of the testes with high frequency. USG can determine whether a mass is intra or extra testicular and can determine the volume and anatomical location of the testicular region and may be used to characterize the contralateral testicle and exclude other lesions and identifying risk factor for the germ cell neoplasia in situ. Next option is CECT. It is most sensitive investigation to evaluate the thorax, abdomen, and pelvis for testicular carcinoma staging, and it is recommended in all patients for staging before orchidectomy, and sensitivity decreases and specificity increase with increasing lymph node cutoff size. If cutoff size is 4 or more than 4 mm, then sensitivity is 93% and specificity is 58%. If cutoff size increase more than 10 or 10, the sensitivity decreases to 37% and specificity increases to 100%. MRI, FDG, PET, and bone scan also used in further follow-up, but there is no evidence to support use MRI, FDG, PET, bone scan for staging in the testicular carcinoma. Next is serum tumor markers support the diagnosis of the testicular carcinoma, and markers may be indicative of germ cell testis histology, tumor histology, and disease staging. Risk also used for risk stratification and monitor treatment response and detect disease relapse. Markers obtained at time of the diagnosis and after orchidectomy for staging and prognostic classification purpose and post chemotherapy for monitor response and to monitor relapse after the completion of therapy and in the patients on surveillance. Alpha fetoprotein is increased in non-seminomatous tumor like yolk sac tumor, embryonal carcinoma, and teratoma. And no, in pure seminoma and choriocarcinoma, alpha fetoprotein not increased. Half life of alpha fetoprotein is 5 to 7 days. Next is beta HCG is elevated in 20 to 40% of the low stage non-seminomatous germ cell tumors and 40 to 60% of advanced non-seminomatous tumors. Approximately 15% of seminomas secrete beta HCG, and choriocarcinoma and embryonal carcinoma also secrete beta HCG, and half-life of HCG is 24 to 36 hours. LDH is elevated in 20% of low-stage germ cell tumors and 20 to 60% of advanced germ cell tumors. It correlates with bulk of the disease and mainly used for prognostic assessment of germ cell tumor at time of diagnosis, and the half-life of LDH is 24 hours. All tumor markers reaches at normal level after 4 half-lives. Placenta alkaline phosphate and gamma glutamyl transpeptide increases in seminoma. Next is radical immuno-orchidectomy. We should avoid delay more than 1 to 2 weeks or should avoid a scrotal approach when testicular carcinoma is suspected. It establishes histological diagnosis and gives T staging, and it is curative in 80 to 85% stage 1 seminoma and 70 to 80% stage 1 non-seminoma. Testis sparing surgery is offered in case with synchronous bilateral tumor or metachronous contralateral tumors or in patients with a solitary testis in order to attempt to preserve fertility or hormonal function. Testis sparing surgery should only be offered together with the frozen section examination. Contralateral biopsy is used to exclude presence of germ cell neoplasia in situ. The indication for biopsy is patient with high risk factor for germ cell neoplasia in situ with like history of germ cell tumor with testicular volume less than 12 mm or history of cryptorchidism and age more than 40 years. If age is more, age less than 40 years, if age more than 40 years, then no required of contralateral biopsy and suspicious lesion on pre-op USG. Sperm cryopreservation should be offered to all men who is planning for future paternity and undecided about your about his paternity. And because 52% men are oligos, 52% men have oligospermia at diagnosis, and 20% are azoospermic at time of the diagnosis. Almost all patients will become azoospermic after chemotherapy, and parameter returns at the level in 50% of patients at 2 years and in 80% at 5 years. The recovery of spermatogenesis after radiation therapy for seminoma may take 2 to 3 years or more. These are all above explained diagnostic options are strongly recommended by EU guidelines as summarized in this table. Next, treatment options. Treatment for germ cell neoplasia in situ depends upon three factors: patient desire for future paternity, and secondly, presence or absence of normal contralateral testes, and patient desire to avoid testosterone replacement therapy. There are three options for in situ carcinoma observation: low dose radiotherapy up to 18 to 20 gray in fractions of 10 fractions and with 2 gray dose. And next is radical orchidectomy, most definitive treatment. If in situ carcinoma is diagnosed and the contralateral test is normal, then preferred treatment is orchidectomy or should be kept in close observation. But 5-year risk of developing testicular carcinoma in observation is 50%. Chemotherapy is significantly less effective and the cure rates are dose dependent. Seminoma is, treatment for seminoma stage 1. There are three treatment options: prevalence and adjuvant chemotherapy with single agent carboplatin with 1 or 2 dose, and followed by, this patient is followed with CT scan. And next option is prophylactic radiotherapy. It is given in periodic region only or periodic and if you like loads. In this, after radiotherapy, routinely CT scan is not required. According to risk adapted treatment for low risk group with tumor size less than 4 cm or and no radiotherapy invasion, preferred treatment is observation. And if for the high risk group with tumor size more than 4 cm and radiotherapy invasion, preferred treatment is chemotherapy. If both patient is not fit for both the option, then next option should be radiotherapy. These are guidelines as explained above have strong recommendations. And treatment for stage 2A and B seminoma. For stage 2A, there are 2A and B, there are two options. Preferred treatment is chemotherapy with 3 cycles of BEP or 4 cycles of EP. If patient is compromises with respiratory system and GFR is less than 4 cycles of EP is used. And next alternative option is radiotherapy with 30 gray dose in 15 fractions with 2 gray dose in each fraction. But in case of stage 2B, all are similar as stage 2A, except in the radiotherapy, additional boost-up dose of 6 gray is given in 3 fractions with 2 gray dose. Patient is followed with CT or tumor markers. And treatment for stage 2C and 3 is preferred treatment is primary chemotherapy, and the regimes and number of cycles are determined by IGCC group. The seminoma is divided into 2 groups only: good prognostic group and intermediate prognostic. For good prognostic group, there is 3 cycles of BEP or 4 cycles of EP, and in the intermediate group, the 4 cycles of BEP and or the 4 cycles of VIP is given at 21 days of interval. Residual mass after chemotherapy in the seminoma is seen in 58 to 80% of patients, and 50% to 66% cases show spontaneous resolution after a median time 12 to 18 months. The histology of the residual mass is necrosis is seen in 90% cases and viable malignancy in 10% cases. And post chemotherapy, radiotherapy has no role in the residual mass. Treatment, if residual mass is less than 4 cm, it has 0 to 4% risk of malignancy, then patient should be kept in. So patient should be kept in observation. And if mass is more than 3 cm, it has 13 to 55% chances of malignancy. So patient should be get FDG PET. If FDG PET is negative, then patient should keep in observation. And if FDG PET is positive, then we should do post chemotherapy surgery. And after post chemotherapy surgery, if histology show viable malignancy, then give two additional cycle of chemotherapy. And if necrosis is present, then keep in follow up. And treatment for relapse seminoma is categorized in three groups. First, the chemotherapy naive relapse. It is seen in patients who is on surveillance stage 1 and stage 1 or 2B after radiotherapy. In the stage 1 surveillance patient relapse cases, give dog-like radiotherapy and treatment for stage 1 to 2B after radiotherapy. Preferred treatment is first-line chemotherapy. Post-chemotherapy early relapse has poor prognosis and may have teratoma at the site of relapse. If tumor markers are negative, then first get biopsy and then after biopsy give chemotherapy. If in the biopsy teratoma is present, then do surgical resection. And post chemotherapy late relapse is in the case preferred treatment is surgery. Pure seminoma accounts less than 80% relapse up later. And patient who relapse after the single agent carboplatin should be considered in chemo naive, and patient should receive first line cisplatin based chemotherapy. And the next is non-seminomatous germ cell tumor. Treatment for stage 1. There is again three options: surveillance, adjuvant chemo with one or two cycles of BP, and third option is nerve sparing RPLND, which has a diminished role in this treatment. Approximately 70% stage 1 tumors cured with orchidectomy alone. And we should offer surveillance or risk adapted treatment based on the lymphovascular invasion in patients with stage 1 has strong recommendation. And risk adapted treatment for seminoma is in this group. Patients are divided in two risk groups, low risk and high risk group, according to lymphovascular invasion. For the low risk group, standard treatment is surveillance. And if patient is not fit for surveillance, then give adjuvant chemo with one cycle of BEP. And if both options are not suitable for this any patient, then do nerve sparing RPLND. And for the high risk group, standard treatment is one cycle of chemo. And other option is nerve sparing RPLND or surveillance. And if relapse occurs, then treat according to IGCC CG risk classification with chemotherapy or resect mass if residual present. As all treatment options have strong recommendation as discussed in the previous slide. And treatment for stage 1 as germ cell tumor, if alpha fetal protein or beta acid increase or fail to normalize after orchidectomy, it indicates the presence of the metastasis. So further evaluated with USG of contralateral testes. If contralateral tumor is excluded and repeat imaging is required if lateral is older than the 3 weeks, and give chemotherapy as an initial treatment. And treatment for say 2A, B and for non-seminomatous germ cell. If in the stage 2A markers are positive, then give chemotherapy with 3 cycles of BP and do surgical resection if residual is present. And in case of the negative marker in 2A, there is two options, either nerve sparing RPLND or follow-up. In the nerve sparing RPLND, after nerve sparing RPLND, if histology is pathological stage 1, then keep in follow-up. And if pathological stage 2A or B is found, then keep in follow-up or give 2 cycles of BEP. But in follow-up after 6 weeks, if disease progress, then repeat serum marker, and if serum markers are positive, then give again give chemotherapy and resect the residual mass. If markers are negative, then narosporin RP-LND or chemotherapy can be given. And if no change in the disease progression, then do narosporin RP-LND. And in case of regression, keep in follow-up. Stage 2B, treatment for stage 2B, non-subnematous germ cell tumor. Preferred treatment is chemotherapy, 3 cycle of BEP or 4 cycle EP. If patient is compromised with respiratory system, avoid bleomycin. And patient should keep in follow-up with abdomen pelvic CT or X-ray chest or CT thorax and serum tumor markers. They are categorized in 3 groups. If negative markers with no residual mass or mass less than 1 centimeter, then standard treatment is observation. And if mass is equal or more than 1 centimeter with negative markers, then preferred treatment is bilateral RP-LND. And in the biopsy, after in the histology, after RP-LND, if teratoma is present, then keep in follow-up. And if viable malignancy is present, then give 2 additional cycle in chemotherapy. And third is elevated tumor marker, give second line chemotherapy. And treatment for stage 2C and 3 non-seminoma. Best induction chemotherapy with cisplatin-based regime is the initial approach used for treatment of clinical stage 2C and 3. The specific number and regimens are based on, again, this stratification classification. They are categorized in 3 groups. For the good prognosis, again, same as seminoma, 3 cycle of BEP and 2 cycle of 4 cycle of EP and resect residual mass if present. And in the case of intermediate prognosis and poor prognosis, give 4 cycle of BEP standard treatment or VIP if compromised pulmonary functions. And response to chemotherapy and management of the post chemotherapy residual mass in non-symptomatic germ cell, they are classified in 4 groups: complete response with residual mass less than 1 centimeter or up to 1 centimeter with markers negative. Keep treatment for this category is keep in observation. And partial remission with marker negative, residual mass more than one centimeter and markers are negative, then do post chemo RP-LND. And in the both category, partial remission with marker positive and disease progression, treatment option is second line chemo, also known as salvage chemo. And in case of treatment for relapse, non-seminomatous germ cell tumor, same as seminoma chemotherapy naive patient. Now, relapse is seen in stage 1 non-symptomatic germ cell tumor managed with either surveillance or RP-LND, and in stage 2A-B treated with RP-LND alone. And treatment for this category is induction chemotherapy. And post-chemotherapy early relapse is seen within 2 years. And treatment for this category is second line chemo with TIP, VIP or VIP with 4 cycles or high dose chemotherapy or bone marrow transplant. If residual present mass is present, post salvage chemotherapy residual mass resection should be done. Do and post chemotherapy late relapse seen after 2 years. Viable malignancy is seen in 54 to 88%, and malignant transformation seen in 10 to 20%. And the preferred treatment for this category is surgical resection. The histology of post-salvage chemosurgery specimen is characterized by higher rates of viable malignancy, 38% to 53%, and lower rate of the necrosis, 26%, and teratoma, 21 to 30%, compared with those after the first-line chemotherapy. After first-line chemotherapy, histology mainly necrosis is 90%, and viable malignancy is seen in 10% cases. And treatment for brain metastasis associated with, brain mets are associated with choriocarcinoma with very high beta HCG level, and these are highly vascular and tends to be bleed during the chemotherapy. And death rate, 4 to 10% death rate is seen in intracranial bleeding, with intracranial bleeding. 5-year survival with brain mets is 33% in case of disseminated non-seminomatous tumor and 57% in seminoma. There are 5 treatment options for brain mets: chemotherapy with 4 cycle of BEP and followed with resection of the residual mass. Other options are surgical resection, whole brain radiation, and stereotactic radiotherapy with multimodality. And patients are follow-up after curative therapy based on the different risk of relapse depending upon diagnosis or initial treatment. Three major groups are for follow-up. Group first is for follow-up for seminoma stage 1. And tumor markers are repeated up to six monthly up to 3 years. Then in the year for next 2 years, 12 monthly. And CT is recommended 6 monthly up to 2 years, and then at 36 months, 6 months. And follow-up for non-seminoma stage 1, tumor markers should be monitored three monthly up to 2 years, then 6 monthly in the third year, and in the fourth or fifth year, 1 or 2 times. And CT is recommended up to 6 monthly in the first year, and after 1 year, at 12 month and 36 month, and after then 36 monthly after 3 years. And treatment follow up after adjuvant chemotherapy or complete remission for advanced diseases is tumor marker 3 monthly up to 2 year, and then 6 monthly in the after that 2 years. And CT is recommended 1 or 2 times in year 1, and then 12 at 24 month, 36 month, and once at the 60 month. And CT thorax is also recommended in this case 6 monthly in the first year, and then at 24 and 60 months.
Thank you, Dr. Mukesh. Now, Dr. Pawa, you have joined.
Hello, good morning.
Good morning.
My pleasure, always my pleasure.
Thank you very much for having joined us. I think you have listened to our resident who presented.
That was a really nice.
It's basically based on European guidelines, which is most popular nowadays. So, I would invite you to give your comments on the guidelines of the testicular tumors, and plus your practical experience on testicular tumors and how actually you treat these patients. So Dr. Pawa, please.
Yeah, please. Thank you. And this really, Mukesh, comprehensive presentation. He covered very well, nicely covered things in a very short, brief presentation. So chemotherapy part is definitely that's nice, but Dr. Mukesh, I just wanted to comment on this is important, like small tumors now we are having. Like earlier we used to have larger tumors. So that is definitely sometime you can say a little more demanding and more challenging for us. Like a non-seminomous germ cell tumor, small, 1 centimeter. So how to usually we proceed for clinical evaluation as a urologist or practicing onco-urologist. So, in non-seminomatous germ cell or seminomatous, so you very well said frozen section. So now more frequently we are practicing here and taking like especially small tumor, 1 to 2 centimeter, we usually go for frozen section. But sometimes problem remains what to do. Frozen section is not foolproof, and like in it is sometime 50-50 or sometime less than 50% chances that is equivocal. So how to go ahead? Like I'm just putting a clinical scenario, like a 2 centimeter, less than 2 centimeter, 1.5 to 1.5 centimeter size tumor. We explored and suggested for asked for frozen section. Frozen section came, it was equivocal sort of. So how to proceed? It is little sometime practical problem. So it is a small tumor, so we simply excise it and send it for definitive biopsy, and just waiting for 4, 5, 7 days to go for it. You rightly in and that turned non-seminomatous germ cell tumor in final histopathology if it comes. I'm just talking of that particular few, either 3 or 4 cases we had this problem. So that turned non-seminomatous germ cell, and one was seminomatous. So you rightly pointed out that in these cases, how to proceed. You said risk stratification is important, And if there is evidence of lymphovascular invasion, like in this situation, you will go for definitely after high archidectomy, you will go for that surveillance, or you will decide single dose chemotherapy or nerve sparing. So one more point I would like to add in that, in NCCN, they are adding, if there is predominant embryonal cell component. So in decision making, like when you go for surveillance, if it is without lymphovascular involvement, and in case it is not predominantly embryonal cell component. So in those cases, definitely we can prefer for little more conservative. And in those cases, we can go for active surveillance, or we can opt for single dose chemotherapy, depending, discussing with the patient. But in other cases, if it is lymphovascular invasion and predominant embryonal cell carcinoma, in those cases, usually as NCCN, we go ahead for nerve sparing radical retroperitoneal lymph node dissection. So we, in this case, fortunately, there was no lymphovascular invasion, and and embryonal cell component was, it was just 10%, 20%. So we kept that patient on surveillance. So one more question I just wanted from Mukesh. When you say it is relapse, like you mentioned about recurrence, like in a small this tumor, and the markers were normal initially and even after surgery. So how you decide? You have some insight in that. Is it right to ask, no?
Dr. Pindashi? Yes, please, yeah. Please go ahead. Dr. Mukesh.
We would like to say some comment.
Yeah. Dr. Mukesh, yes. Are you?
If mass is, in case of seminoma, if mass is present and tumor marker may or may not increase, and in case of non-seminoma, tumor markers are increases, and mass is present more than 1 centimeter.
In markers are, if you're doing, keeping that patient on surveillance, so initially markers were raised, once after high equipment, markers came to normal level. And after, again.
After and four half times, generally tumor markers become normal. And after this, again, if tumor markers raised, then may...
Okay, right. So this is what I just wanted to emphasize this point. Sometime like in my, this, in that what case scenario I'm discussing, that is like that patient had normal markers, and even after surgery, markers were normal. And this was in risk stratification, it was low risk, like non-seminometer germ cell tumor without lymphovascular invasion and without raised markers. But and we kept that patient on, that patient opted for, because of, I think, some communication and because of this COVID in time. So that patient lost to follow up, and somehow, although the decision was for surveillance, but unfortunately that patient presented us within, I think, 4-5 months with raised markers. And on CT, there was no residual, there was no mass, retroperitoneal lymph nodes. So I think this is an important decision making in risk stratification. This should be a very mutually discussed decision, like these options are there and you can take this decision. You can go for surveillance with very active surveillance. So I think the most of the people now are accepting we can go for single, like in that case, as we decided, simple surveillance. And by default also that patient opted for that active surveillance because of COVID. But chemotherapy, one shot we could have given. Although in that patient, it was normal markers preoperatively and postoperatively. But within 4 months, he had. So this is what I wanted to, like small tumors, we need to be more, now we are getting more cases and where we need to go for proper evaluation, investigation of, as we go for ultrasound. Another point you said, in opposite ultrasound, what are important high risk, like what are suspicion index, how, what suspicion index you will have when you will go for opposite testis biopsy in cases of, with what ultrasound changes you get?
Mukesh, yes.
Micrometers,
that is important. And some with changes with Doppler also you can observe in those cases.
Yeah.
Then thank you, Dr. Priyam, for...
Thank you, Dr. Pava, for bringing out those very important points. I think you brought out some important points like if there is a small tumor, how to proceed. And then now we have that testicular sparing surgery also.
Exactly.
Instead of doing a radical orchidectomy in every patient, that is also being done. And second point was very important that nowadays, because of the very effective curative cytotoxic chemotherapy, the paradigm has shifted from radiotherapy or RPLND, particularly in early stage patients and low risk patients. So even surveillance has become a very important role in low risk and early stage patients. You pointed out rightly that yes, the compliance is a very important factor. And if you think that the compliance may not be good, then definitely giving a one single dose of carboplatin in these patients will be very good in early stage patients rather than sending them only just on surveillance. Yes, that's right. And another, I think, a controversy here is about the residual mass. How do you actually treat residual mass? We all know that, yes, less than 3 centimeter, you can do observation. More than 5 centimeter, either go for a biopsy followed by radiotherapy or residual mass resection. So again, a little bit of controversy whether every mass should be excised or not, or what is the extent of the lymph node dissection in these patients. That is a slight controversial area, and the extent of and then I think the cryopreservation is very important because these are patients who are quite young and most may not have completed their family. So preserving the semen and the sperms before proceeding with radiotherapy or chemotherapy is probably plays a very important role. So I would invite other faculty or any resident who wants to have who has any query regarding this. You're most welcome. Nachiket, are you there? Yes. I think if nobody has any query, I would request Dr. Pava for his last comments, and then I would request the moderator to give the vote of thanks. So Dr. Pava, your last comments on the management of testicular tumors.
You mentioned about that cryopreservation, that is important. That is very important. You very rightly, he presented very well, and then very comprehensively you covered all those points. Then follow-up is also very important in these cases. So a meticulous follow-up is very important up to 5 to 6 years and even later. So good. And second, the fertility is definitely, like, many patients are coming later on, like they have been treated for this testicular tumor, testicular survivors, and then they are coming for this treatment of infertility. And surprisingly, if you are having oligospermia and doing, but they're wandering and they are. So this is important. Cryopreservation is also very important. You highlighted well, and thank you very much for inviting me and a wonderful presentation by your president.
Thank you, Dr. Pava. And I will request now our moderator, Dr. Sanjeev Jaiswal, to give a vote of thanks and wrap up the session. Sanjeev?
Hello. Thank you, Dr. Pava, sir, for joining us and share your experience. And thank you, Shivan, sir. Thank you all.
Thank you, Dr. Sanjeev. Dr. Pava, just I will let you know that yes, our residents and our moderators are sitting in our classroom, and we are having it a hybrid kind of thing.
That's good.
So thank you very much once again, Dr. Pava, and all the faculty members and the residents, and all those who might have joined us today. Thank you very much.
Thank you. My pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.